Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. Today I'll show you how I can make a great battery pack using a unique type of LiPo cell. Here I got a bunch of them. If you ask me from where I get them, well, they can be found pretty much everywhere. Normally they came from this metal colorful metal tube, which will lure you in picking them up if you come across them. The battery are the type 2400, which stand for the dimension of them, and they came with a quite unique milliamp rating of around 1500 mAh. Now if you're planning to play with them, do them in a safer manner. And it goes without further saying that you are being responsible for your own safety when it came to work with pretty much any type of battery, not just LiPo, so be aware. I start by getting the cells sorted and removing the cap top 10 from them prior to inspect the cell. Any cells which are a bit dented or severely damaged will be going straight to my recycling box. The good one will be tested not only for the voltage but also for checking them how they behave. After some charging and discharging cycles, I kept a close eye on them, especially for any heaters, meaning battery which likes to get hot. Those also will be separating and get few more checks on them. After the cells are sorted and tested, I grab the caliper and I start measuring the cell. Oh, calm down, it's made out of plastic. Gotcha. And the size of them is about 20mm high and 40mm long. Then I went and I made a simple holder in 1-2-3D design. Then after a few minutes I got a simple design which can be multiplied, meaning it can be adapted by your needs. I have designed few battery holders for this type of battery. I did for 1 cell as well for 2, 3, 4, 5 and even 9 cell holder. This is quite versatile battery holder which offer multiple configuration like the voltage, the size and as well the capacity. This is how many cells you will be getting in parallel of the final battery. Also something far better, it has a hot swap capability. Mean that in case of a failure of an individual cell, it can be replaced pretty much without any hassle, with plenty room for it to be implemented in any design and not only to be limited to power banks. After finishing the model, I have started printing some one cell holder prior to test the hot swap capability. Here I got the cells module done. This is just an experiment to them to see it will fit and what is the best way to tackle the main problem, the hot swap capability. Which it is to offer a small grip to the cell, to the module. This means to have a capability of preventing the cell from falling out and to not damage it while it's being able to maintain a strong connection. The connection has to be great but not too great, something similar can be seen on your TV remote. And after some iteration I found two perfect candidates. First one has a little spacer created from this styrofoam sheet and are placed between the nickel strip and the 3D model. This will offer a decent grip along with a decent connection. But the second one turned out to be much better and stable. After the main tabs are added and soldered in place, I got some double-sided tape and cut some pieces of it and stick them on the side of the battery terminal. After that I bent the battery terminal back and like that it offered a cushion effect under the cell and also offering a better grip. Now let's make a simple 12V battery. For that a holder of 3 cells has to be printed. And after getting some nickel strips and cut it down to size, can be inserted in the 3D module and solder it in its place. After we can add the cells and connect them in series prior to get a higher voltage. But remember the capacity will remain the same. But I have to emphasize that for the series connection as well, if you are doing it in parallel, use some thinner wire from a cable. They will be acting like a fuse in the event of mishandling the cells. Or if they are in parallel, a too high voltage cell will like to overcharge the under voltage cell, leading to a cell getting damaged or puffing out. After the battery is done, we can test the voltage and it's pretty much stable and it works as expected. Now the only thing remains is to give it a load and you can see the battery worked and we are done. The module has a big potential and I hope it inspires you on how small is too small or how big is too big. Till then, stay sharp. Detail regarding the 3D file can be found in the video description. I hope you have learned something interesting today and I shall see you all in the other next video. Till then, have a nice day and thank you very much for watching. See ya.